Hello friends, I'm Shaurya Mishra. Welcome you to your own YouTube channel, Vision Care Advisor. Friends, in this video, we will discuss about the limbal dermoid. We will discuss what is the limbal dermoid, the causes of limbal dermoid, the complications of limbal dermoid, how can we diagnose the limbal dermoid, and the treatment of the limbal dermoid. So, without taking much time, let's get started. A limbal dermoid is a mass of histologically normal tissue in an abnormal location, present at the intersection of the cornea and sclera, and usually located in the inferotemporal quadrant of the limbus, and it can involve the more central cornea. It is consisting of a mass of collagenous tissue containing dermal elements, which is covered by stratified squamous epithelium. The cornea or sclera underlying a dermoid can be very thin or even absent. It is present in early childhood. Lesions are whitish, solid, fairly well circumscribed, elevated, vascularized, and can have hair arising from their surface. Lesions are occasionally very large and may virtually encircle the limbal dermoid. Let's know the causes of limbal dermoid. The causes of limbal dermoid are not known exactly, but some patients may have due to other medical conditions or symptoms that impact a limbal dermoid. So let's know the complications of the limbal dermoid. Limbal dermoid cysts are non-cancerous, but sometimes the dermoid can grow and affecting the visual axis that may impair vision. If a cyst becomes large, it can also cause astigmatism. Astigmatism occurs because the cyst affects the shape of the eye and this causes the eye to focus differently. From time to time, this astigmatism can cause amblyopia or lazy eye. Sometimes, limbal dermoid may also cause redness and irritation in the affected eye. Now, come to know, how can we diagnose the depth of the limbal dermoid? Ultrasound biomicroscopy or anterior segment optical coherence tomography may be helpful to determine the depth. Now come to the part of the treatment of the limbal dermoid. Treatment is not required in many cases. Wait and watch is often the best approach, especially if the patient is young. The patient should have a full eye exam to check their vision and to look for astigmatism. If astigmatism is present, then glasses may be prescribed. If there is concern of lazy eye or amblyopia, the patient may need to be treated with a patch on the other eye to help the vision develop. If the cyst causes redness or irritation, steroid eye drops may be used. If the limbal dermoid is becoming larger or blocking the vision and patient is concerned due to appearance, cosmetically, surgery can be performed and a small dermoid can undergo simple excision. But lamellar keratosclerotomy may be required for large lesions. I hope this video would be helpful for you. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned for more updates and don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Please do remember to get check your vision yearly and see the world clearly.